The Cooperative Recovery Initiative grant that was awarded to U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service and Fish and Game is to increase the population of Karner blue butterflies here in Concord, New Hampshire. The Concord Pine Barrens is the only location in New England where the Karner blue butterfly lives. We have a recovery goal of 3,000 butterflies. In order to achieve the goal of the grant, we laid out a few actions that we would take over 3 years. Our first action was to manage all occupied subpopulations.
So we have different steps we use to maintain the Pine Barrens as suitable habitat for the Karners. Part of that is tree clearing, so we want to make sure there's open, sunny spots for the lupin to grow. In this spot specifically where we are, we have opened it up by doing some tree shearing. And we also have had a prescribed burn in here. This was one of the patches we burned in the fall of 2016. So when we burn, it flushes nutrients and the lupin is able to come back tenfold. Our ideal process is to bronto or remove trees, tree shear, and then we would mow an area to get everything kind of an even layer. And then we would burn it and then seed drill it with lupin. And then the habitat would come back ideally to what we would want.
Our next action was to create two new subpopulations of Karner blue butterflies. And then finally, we were captive rearing and releasing butterflies to occupy the new habitat.
In our captive rearing facility, we raise all life stages of the Karner blue butterfly. So we collect females from the wild and we set up these egg cups which provide water, nectar, honey, lupin. And so we'll collect the wild females. We do it after about 5 or 6 days after we've seen them in the wild to give them time to have mated. And so we'll bring them back and we'll collect the eggs from her and first brood. And then we'll raise those until they get to the chrysalis stage. And then we have them enclose or hatch out as adults. And then we will release those out into the wild. And then we'll do the same thing again once we collect all the eggs to grow and do the second brood on.
Funding from the grant allowed New Hampshire Fish and Game staff and seasonals to monitor the outcomes of activities.
We do distance transect monitoring for second brood Karners. We have a set length of transect, normally it's about 100 meters, in a plot that's known to have lupin in it or would be a good habitat or sites where we know we have Karners. And so we have the transects, and with that transect white pole we have, we walk to the different flags, and when we are walking, we're seeing if we're flushing any Karners. And what that does is it gives us a population estimate.
By managing the Pine Barrens to improve habitat quality for the Karner blue butterfly, we're also increasing nectar available for a variety of pollinators, such as the frosted elfin, bumblebees, other native ground nesting bees, moths, and various ants and beetles. The goal of the grant is to create more habitat for a self-sustaining population of Karner blue butterfly in the future.